So I had him, hope that didn't make you feel weird.
We'll see. Okay. Yeah.
So what happened, he's in our games, and, you know, I would watch him, and he'd just be, like, really gingerly walking around.
Yeah.
And then once he warmed up, he was fine. And actually, he'd have some amazing performances. But then I would see him in practice, and he'd just be, like, standing still. I'm like, what's up? He's like, oh, nothing. I'm like, what's wrong? He's like, just some pain. I'm like, what do you mean, some pain?
Yeah.
I'm like, had him do some movements. I'm like, all right. Dude, I've told his parents, I said, you gotta go see the doctor.
Yeah.
Because the area you have your sort of lack of mobility in, like, I know what that is because I broke my back,
right,
too.
I've been there,
so I'm like, you gotta go.
Yeah.
It was really good. And what you said, I was just like, you see, like,
right,
one thing happens and then another thing happens and then another thing happens. So,
yeah, the back stuff is, and these young guys, is, I mean, I think that's going to be the number one presenting issue for a lot of soccer players, just because you can't get good at soccer without putting your body through that.
The back.
Yeah, and those vertebrae just take a tremendous amount of force. And
so from
what the solution is, other than strengthening everything else, because they can come in funny positions all the time, and I bet that's what happened to him, because I bet he fell, you know, some funny angle, and he'll, like, a fairly lanky, you know, developing kid. So,
well, what happened to me was I was on the ground and my feet were extended and I was like this, and then someone fell on top of me and I felt like,
oh, you just got crunched.
I got crunched. Yeah. It was awful.
Right. Because you weren't gonna. You're in. I don't know, man. As I remember you, you were not in a position where you were gonna get knocked in a funny angle.
No.
Without.
No.
Somebody helping you.
Right.
Basically.
Right.
When I was in high school, I had those pictures of me playing, and I'm like, why is my leg next to my ear? Like,
right.
What am I doing?
Right.
As you're developing, yeah, I mean, a lot of that strength needs to come centrally first, and that's just not a
problem. My biggest concern, and again, is really, like, it's obviously the back, but it's the hips.
Well, I just mean the back is what we're going to see people for.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, that's the sentinel that there's something going on,
right,
in that whole apparatus that's problematic. Like, you know, we're trying to cut down hours spent playing, but I'm not sure that that's the right solution. I think it's more just don't, if you're flailing around all over the place, yeah, stuff's going to go wrong.
Right.
But if you can kind of bring everything back and make it come back to efficient, that's central, stabilize things centrally, I think that protects you from.
That's why I do a lot of agility training. I told you about the boxes that I have. And I make sure that they're coordinated and can move their body weight quickly up and down,
right,
east and west. And it's just like...
That's not easy for a 15-year-old kid, right?
Yeah.
Or a 13-year-old kid. Yeah.
And I have some kids that are really efficient and others that are just like, I'm like, are the wires loose in there? Or like, I'm like...
Well, you think about it though, man. Like, a year earlier, they were a foot shorter.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, you might
sign up. Absolutely. Yeah, no, that's true. Right
on.
And my oldest son is 10. He's gonna be so much taller than me. Like, he's 10 years old and wears a size 7 shoe already, you know? But it's funny, he's like a deer walking, you know, and
yeah,
a baby, yeah, a little baby deer.
Spindly.
But I make him do this stuff and it's amazing how quickly he's sort of refined and tightened his movements,
right,
and more efficient. We got to continue to work on it.
Yeah, and I find that once you teach people about kind of firing their transversus abdominis, just as a central stabilizing technique, people take it and they go with it. And it sticks, which to me is surprising, but I think it just kind of speaks to how it feels good to have those efficient movements.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the same thing you're getting these kids to do with agilities. You know, they realize, like, there's things they can do here to keep their foot from landing too far out laterally.
Right.
That's smart. That's good.
The other thing is, like, I need to identify a few more effective training or hip strengthening or hip mobility exercise. Because again, we do the, you know, you're down on your fours, you're sort of
rotating
and those sort of things, in and out, up and back. But again, that might be part of the problem.
I mean, I think if it's your own body weight,
it's all body weight.
It's safe.
I can do anything non-body weight. Yeah. Nothing anymore.
It's interesting too, because they get a good stress. A lot of times you have to go to the extremes of flexion, abduction, or adduction, but then that's also when you can kind of irritate stuff in the hip joint, so there's a balance there.
Right.
But I think, and maybe one thing that might make sense would be that I'll get with our yoga instructor. I think I might have mentioned that before.
Mm-hmm.
She has some, like, basically, like, you put yourself in like the warrior pose,
mm-hmm.
with the legs, and then you rotate.
Yep.
And that you're getting tremendous range of motion at the hip joint.
Okay.
But it's all within this like thing where you're stabilized here.
Right.
And then you rotate. It's all functional, as
right.
opposed to like trying to touch the back of your head with your foot or something,
right.
which is just bad. I gotta write some notes, man.
Yeah.
So I actually have this workstation here,
mm-hmm.
and you're free to hang out. But if I don't write my notes, Marcy's gonna bring it.